What's up, everybody? It's me, your boy Q. Welcome back for another Quesday, where I am talking about how I've tried to unfuck my life. You heard me, unfuck my life. Hashtag unfuck my life. And this time, I have changed the format to widescreen. And now I'm trying to remember where to stare, because when you turn the camera to widescreen, it kind of throws off my eye line. So I'm trying to look at this dot and I feel like, who am I talking to? Have you ever just been moving along, not thinking about anything, moving forward with your life, enjoying yourself, having a good time, and just out of nowhere, bam, something happens that completely derails everything? I know you guys know what I'm talking about. I know a lot of you guys have experienced it, but I want to talk about when you have such a derailment that it absolutely threatens to change and shift the very trajectory of your life, your physical life. So Quincy, what happened? What are you talking about? Once upon a time, in the year of our Lord, 2013, could have been 2014, I was a television producer at that time for a television series called The Sing-Off. For those of you who know, it was an a cappella singing show that put the famous group Pentatonix on the map. So let me back up a little bit. Maybe a year or two prior, I had had a couple of bouts of dizziness out of the blue. I was told basically that it was vertigo. People have vertigo, it comes and goes. It's pretty common, but they go back. They settle, they go away, you're fine. Fast forward, I'm at work. We were shooting one of the a cappella groups. We're downtown LA, we're on a rooftop. So I have my camera and then I looked down, and when I looked back up, literally the whole world started spinning. I braced myself like, whoa, you know, let me sit down for a second. And so I lay back and I'm waiting for the spinning to stop, because usually vertigo lasts a few minutes. So I'm, you know, thinking, oh, I'm gonna lay back and it's gonna stop. So after a few minutes, it never stopped. I had to call it an early wrap because I was just too dizzy. Everything was kind of spinning around, and I'm on top of a skyscraper downtown Los Angeles. And I'm thinking, all right, just get me home. I'll lay down, I'm gonna take a nap. After I take a nap, it's probably gonna go away. So when I woke up, it wasn't gone. And the next day, it wasn't gone. And I began to panic. Went to the ER, and they told me that I was having vertigo again. Apparently this is vertigo. They told me that I could try some head movements or something, and they gave me some medication for nausea. Nothing worked. Didn't go away. Then I decided to go to urgent care. Then they thought, well, we'll give you a shot in the ass, and told me the same thing. Do this exercise, lay your head this way, lay it back. The little sand granules have slipped out of where they're supposed to be in your inner ear, and they're just wreaking havoc in your freaking nervous system, in your brain, making you think the world is spinning when it's not. None of that worked. The shot didn't work, anti-nausea meds didn't work, head exercises didn't work. Days and days and days passed, and I could no longer function. You know what it feels like when you're a kid and you spin in one spot really, really fast, and then you stop, but then the world keeps moving after you stop? That's exactly what I was experiencing for days and days on end. I couldn't even stand up, couldn't walk anymore, because when I would stand up to walk, I would fall over or I would bump into things because I completely lost all ability to balance myself. The slightest bit of motion felt like a major earthquake, exaggerated 100 times more. And because everything kept spinning, my eyes were darting back and forth like this. I don't know if I'm doing it right, but something like that. My eyes were trying to find a focal point, a place to focus. After seeing three different doctors, I just didn't know what was going on any longer. So now I am really afraid. Every symptom that you look up in the internet is going to inform you that this is the end. Of course, I am self-diagnosing myself because clearly none of the professionals can figure out what the hell is going on with me. I can't see, I can't walk, and the world doesn't stop moving even when I'm standing still. Now I got all of these bills that I have to pay, emergency bills, urgent care bills. So I'm frustrated, I'm pissed, I'm scared. I don't know what is happening to me. And finally we found the house clinic, which was an ear, nose, throat clinic in Los Angeles. First thing they wanted to do was a CAT scan to make sure that I didn't have any bleeding on the brain or I didn't have a brain tumor. I was convinced at that point that I had a major giant fucking brain tumor. And this was basically the end of my life. So of course, more fuckery. This is even more fuckery. So I waited for the CAT scan results because I had definitely, absolutely convinced myself that I was dying of a brain tumor or brain cancer or something, thanks to the www. Bullshit. It came back negative. So I didn't have a brain tumor. I didn't have brain cancer. I didn't have a bleed on the brain. I'm just reading all of these things about what causes vertigo. And it really pissed me off because I always thought vertigo was a thing. I thought it was the thing. In fact, vertigo is a symptom of another thing. You don't have vertigo, you're experiencing vertigo. Something else is going wrong in your body. Finally, they did this last ditch test to test my vestibular system. So let me give you guys the explanation of the vestibular system. The vestibular system is broken up into two. You have one half in the right ear and the other half in the left ear. Because you're looking at me on camera, that might be reversed. I don't know. The vestibular system controls your balance, your sense of space, monocular vision, movement and motion and direction is also the thing that makes you feel grounded and stuck to the earth. Also deals with your fine motor skills. So when you see babies, babies do that. Their fine motor skills have not yet been developed. They run these tests, they put me in this big machine, this crazy chair, and they put these space age goggles over my eyes with laser lights in them, and then they're squirting different temperatures of water in my inner ear, and they're turning me upside down and sideways and to the side in this chair like Magic Mountain. Basically, came back that my right vestibular system showed no response to any stimuli. They were like dead cold fish. Turns out my right vestibular system had somehow just died. And once that happened, it sent my body into outer space. Your body lost all of its shocks. I'm petrified. What does it mean if your vestibular system is gone? Like what does that mean? What does that mean? Does that mean I am permanently disabled? Will I ever walk again? Will I ever drive again? Will I have to be taken care of for the rest of my life? This is not fair on my husband. He now has to take care of me for the rest of my life. And that thought, it hurt. It hurt so bad because I felt like now I'm going to be a burden. And I'm only 30 something years old. I'm 2,000 miles away from home. And then the thought of me having to go back home to be taken care of by my parents and my siblings, what's the quality of life that I'm gonna have at this point as somebody who can't take care of themselves? I never had to think about what life would be like as a disabled person. I took it for granted that I would always be able-bodied. You never think that something could happen that could, out of the blue, change your whole life. More fuckery in my life, thinking I had all these dreams and then I had all these regrets about things that I didn't do or I should have done better or I shouldn't have done, and the things that I had been so afraid of going after, and now I can't. Now I can't. All I could do was sit in the doctor's office and be told that you are going to be permanently disabled, and there's nothing that really can be done to fix it. Oh well. I'm furious. I'm furious at life. I'm furious at the doctor. I'm furious at what has happened to me. I just kept asking, why me? Why me? None of this makes sense. All right, if I was a smoker and I smoked 10 packs of cigarette a day and now you just told me that I got lung cancer. Okay, I can almost accept that there was something that I did that led me to this disability. Even if I was walking across the street and I got hit by a car or slipped and fell and hit my head, something to tell me why this is happening to me. Why is this happening to me? I couldn't understand why this was happening to me. And they couldn't find the reason. All they could tell me is that it seems like you possibly had an inner ear infection, that it could have been a head cold, and I could have blown my nose in the wrong way and forced bacteria or something into the inner ear. It sat there a long time and it wreaked havoc. It basically ate away at the function of the vestibular system until it was dead. And it's never coming back. They said that if I had have gotten it checked out the year prior when I had those few bouts of vertigo, they might have been able to have caught it in advance. So that was really, really good to know. And luckily the nurse came and comforted me after the doctor because I literally had a breakdown. She told me over time, the brain would adapt and eventually begin to compensate for what was lacking over here. I had to basically go through daily rehabilitation exercises to train my brain and my body how to see again. Hand-eye coordination had to be basically retrained, like from an infant, like being a baby. Like I had to learn how to follow a finger, how to walk straight, and how to move my hand this way, that way. And the condition that I suffer from is called vestibular neuritis. So they gave me a bunch of antibiotics, a bunch of antivirals to take just in case there was any remnants, and they gave me a steroid to bring down the swelling. And I forget the name of the steroid, but it's the one that makes you turn into Mr. Potato Head. Oh. Not only do I have moon face, the world won't stop spinning. I can't drive. The only way that I could see was to force one eye closed and to try to focus with one eye, because with one eye closed, the darting would stop. Thing is, over time, the spinning began to slow down and it became more of a general kind of wooziness. So after my eyes stopped doing this, and the world stopped spinning within the year, I had double vision now. So I no longer could see one person or one thing. Everything was in twos, but they slowly began to merge. But they never completely merged as one. My balance never came back and my coordination never came back. Nothing ever came back 100%. And it took, I would say, about 6 months before I was able to independently function, and then another 6 months before I felt a new normal. I became accustomed to the feeling, I guess. My body adapted to feeling that way. So I don't even remember what it feels like to be normal. This is my normal, and I don't know any different anymore. And it's just weird how you adapt and how you have to adapt in order to survive. I never thought that I would be facing a period in my life where I was physically unable to function. Something so small, something that's not even anything you think about, could in a snap be gone. And your whole world is spinning out of control. Literally. My husband nicknamed me Dizzy Gillespie. My friends liked to see me try to run. I would literally just fall over. So, you know, it was some fun moments in having this crazy disability. That experience put so much into perspective for me. All of the inconsequential things that we allow into our lives, into our space, to worry us, to make us feel less than, to stress us out. All of that fuckery that we allow into our lives, that don't mean anything in the end. Because when you're facing either death or you're facing the possibility of having zero quality of life, which is like a living death, the things in your life that are important to you become very clear. Your regrets become very clear. Your fears become very clear. Your life flashes before your eyes. So much comes into focus when you're faced with a life that you can't live any longer. That fucked me up. I cannot feel pitiful. All this woe is me because this is happening to me, this why me, why not me? I have to learn how to stop asking that question, why me, why not you? What makes you so special that life and circumstance won't happen? Man, you wanna talk about gratitude? Developing a sense of gratitude for your life, for the small things, the things that we don't even pay attention to. That's part of what I wanted to share this story about, because I feel like for so long, I focused on the next, the next, the next, the next. You know, I never stopped to sit still and appreciate all of the small things that were happening. You're always in a moving car trying to get to a destination, and along the way, you never stop. It's a difference between walking somewhere in your neighborhood and driving somewhere. There's a lot that you miss. And when you are faced with a life debilitating disability or a life debilitating disease, then suddenly you realize how much you've missed of your own life. Always focused on the next. Your vestibular system is something you never have to think about, right? It just works. It just is. You focus on looking good. You focus on hitting the gym and making sure your skin is right, blah, blah, blah. You ain't thinking about the things that just automatically work. You just trust that they're gonna always work. Your focus is always forward. It's never in the now. You never stop to be. And I had to stop because my body knocked my ass down. It literally knocked my ass down. There was nothing I could do but be in the now. That's all I could do. It was be in the now and learn how to appreciate what I have. And when I'm telling you, when it finally ended, when I finally felt somewhat whole again, I just wanted to celebrate. I just wanted to celebrate. I just wanted to do things that I hadn't done before, to challenge my fears. One of the things that I always loved to do and always wanted to do but was too afraid to do was sing publicly. And that was one of my resolutions after recovering. I went and I sang twice. You can win, child. Get over your head when you only got yourself to blame. You can't win, child. You can't get even when you can't get out of the game. You can't get out of the game. You can't get out of the game. Second time, I tanked, I was horrible. But I did it. And on my 40th birthday, I threw a party and it was called Sweat 40. At 40 years old, all I wanted to do was dance. A year prior to that, I couldn't dance anymore. I couldn't walk. I just wanted to celebrate coming into 40 and being able to freaking spin around and kick up my legs. I barely could do that. I was, shit, falling off balance, but I made it look good. I made it look like it was on purpose because that's that old house music stuff. You can kind of fall over and make it look cool and just catch yourself and just spin back around. If it had not have been for that experience of me not being able to even consider ever possibly doing anything I wanted to do again, through all that fuckery, I gained an inner peace, more joy in my life. You feel brand new when you come up out of that. It's a lot that I've gone through prior to this journey that I'm undoing, that I'm unfucking. This is my takeaway, and I hope that you get something from this is that stop where you are and think about the things that you haven't done for yourself, for your life, the things that you overlook, that you take for granted, and think about within a blink of an eye, you're faced with not being able to do anything anymore. Find love, go to school and get the degree you wanted to get. Apologize to the person that you hurt. Just stroll down your block and say hi to your neighbor. To stop and do the things that you always think, oh, I should do this, but I'll put it off because I got this and this and that to do. Now just imagine, without any fault of your own, some catastrophic event in your life making all of those things impossible for you. You don't want to have that. You don't have to have my experience in order for you to do what you need to do now, to be in the now, to live in the now, to appreciate the now, to not live with regrets, to not live with fear. You don't need that fuckery. I went through that fuckery. There are some people out there who are going through that fuckery. I am a person living with a disability, you know, and it sounds weird to say, but it is the truth. And I want to say to those people out there who are living with a disability and they're holding their head high and they're not allowing their disability to define their lives, I applaud you. You inspire the fuckery out of me. But guys, if you liked what you heard, if anything I said inspired you, please share this video. Share this video. Don't forget to like it. Comment. If I say something you don't like, you have something to say. But when I say something you do like, you don't say nothing. So I don't really know if you really like it or not. So you gotta say something, right? Like, share, comment. To all the heroes out there, born with disabilities, living with disabilities, who have not allowed anything to slow them down, to take away their smiles. Here's to you guys.
Look at this shit.
Look at it.
This is gonna happen.